Hi guys, welcome back to Android Fixation. This is Daryl. Today I'm going to start this video off by thanking all of you guys for the questions you've been asking me. I've been getting a lot of feedback and a lot of questions about a lot of different things. So I made this video in response to some of the questions I've been getting. I'm going to talk about storage. As you know, the Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1 and other Android tablets come in 16 gigabytes or 32 gigabytes. And for some of you guys, 16 is not enough. And a lot of you guys have been asking about the Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1, and it does not have any expansion. So here's what I've done to increase the storage space that I have. Okay, if you've seen my other video, you know I have the Samsung USB adapter for the Galaxy Tab 10.1. And I have this Elego. It's a reader for your micro SD card. And of course I have the SD card itself, and I put this American 10 cent piece next to it so you can see the size of each of these. Okay, so here's what I've done to increase the storage. First, on the tablet, hold on 1 second. On the tablet, to increase storage on the tablet, one of the things I've done was I use Google Music Beta, and I have my MP3s stored online as opposed to having them stored on the device itself. I currently have about 7 gigs worth of music stored on Music Google Beta. So that right away frees up a lot of space. I don't waste any space on my tablet at all for music. I keep it all on Google Music Beta. And I must tell you, when I'm playing songs, I have absolutely no problem with latency. I don't get any lag. There are no delays. The songs don't skip. And songs are cached so that I can play them offline without any problems whatsoever. And I don't have any lag. And I really like this a lot. And this saves a lot of space when you want to play music or what have you on your device. And you don't want to use up space. I'm at my house right now on my network. And as you can see here, the song is playing easily without any delays, any skippage whatsoever. So if you have a lot of music and you don't want to waste up your space, put your music in Google Music Beta. Okay. Another thing I have is I have things like Dropbox and Box.net. Box.net gives you 5 gigs of storage space, and Dropbox will give you 2 gigs of storage space. So that's 7 gigs of space I have for storing things like pictures, which is what I use Dropbox for. I don't put anything else in there. Videos, of course, I put in there, photos and any other files. I have this file here, Android APK. So what I have in here are APKs that are not installed on the tablet. And some of these are installed on the tablet, but some of them are not. So basically, by putting them here, I don't have to have them installed on the tablet. I could keep my space free, and if I want to install something, so let's say I want to go with Heavy Gunner here, I could just tap on this and install the APK right from my Dropbox. And if I don't want the app anymore, if I want to free up some space again, I can just delete it. So I can install apps on the go. I don't have to rely on having a connection. I could copy a file from Dropbox, let's say, and I can put it in my download folder, and I can always have access to it offline. Or if I do have my online connection, I have all of my files here. So this was like a huge help for me, because people thought there were not a lot of apps available for, you know, the tablet, but there are, you know, don't be confused with tablet specific apps versus apps. There are plenty of apps, and you know, with 16 gigs I pretty much filled this thing up. So I've done these things to free up some space. So again, I have my music in Google Music Beta, and I keep pictures and other files in Dropbox and box.net. Now Dropbox has a desktop app, so you could just drag and drop files on to your Dropbox and they'll sync and be on your device. Box.net does not have a desktop client, but you can make one. You could just map a network drive and you'll basically have the same function. You can drag and drop things to your box.net account and they'll be on your tablet. Now going back to this setup over here, okay, now it's gonna be hard to do this with one hand, but I'm gonna try. This is the Elego card reader. I got this off of Amazon and it was only $10, and you know the USB kit was $20, and the card that I have is a 16 gig high capacity card. And I believe one of you guys asked me about that, if high capacity cards will work, and yes they do, and this is one here. So it's 16 gigs. So with this connected to the tablet, I have 32 gigs of space plus 7 gigs of space with my box.net account plus infinite gigs of space with my Google mobile account and 2 gigs of space with my Dropbox account. So I'm not going to run out of space anytime soon. I would like to put this together to show you, but I can't do this with one hand. I promise I will make another video later demonstrating this setup, showing you what it looks like when it's connected to the tablet and how it works. But it's very simple and it all fits in this really compact package here. It's a lot of little pieces to carry around and get lost, but not really, because the secure digital card will go inside the card reader, and then it has a little cap to keep it secured, and of course the cap for the USB adapter. So I hope this was helpful to you guys, you guys that are asking me a lot of questions about storage. If you have any more questions or comments, please post them. You can send me private messages and I will get back to all of you guys. Thank you for watching, and I really appreciate all the feedback that I'm getting. It's really going to help the channel grow. Please follow me on Twitter at Android Fixation and on Facebook at facebook.com/AndroidFixation. Again, I'm still working on my website. When it's up, I hope all you guys join me there. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. You are watching Android Fixation. Thank you.